Welcome to IC Info Channel. In this video, we will show you Amsterdam, the capital of the Netherlands. The video is divided in two parts. Part 1 shows you how Amsterdam looks like. The second part will give you some information about the city, for example, information about interesting places and the public transport. So if you want to know how the Dutch capital looks like, or you are planning a trip to Amsterdam, this video is probably interesting for you. We start now with part 1. Let's watch and discover Amsterdam. Welcome to the second part of this video. If you want to visit Amsterdam, you can reach Amsterdam by traveling by plane or international train. Amsterdam Schiphol Airport is a major international airport which lies not far away from Amsterdam. For many passengers, the train will be the cheapest and most convenient way of getting to Amsterdam city center. And if you take the train to Amsterdam Central Station, then you have a good starting point for exploring the city, because the central station is close to the old center of the Dutch capital. Exploring the city by foot is a good way of discovering the city center. You can join a guided walking tour or just use a map to explore the city yourself. If you want to walk to a point of interest, look for the special signs that point to several sites like squares, museums and parks. You can also use these signs if you want to discover the city by bike. Exploring the city on a bike lets you see more in a day. There are a lot of shops in the city where you can rent a bike, so obtaining a bike should not be difficult. Be careful when you are walking or cycling in the city. People are often moving fast on their scooters and bikes, so always look around when crossing a street. Amsterdam has a lot of canals, so a canal cruise is an absolute must for every first-time visitor. Amsterdam's fantastic architecture is best seen from a sightseeing boat on the canals. You can get on such a sightseeing boat on several places in the center. For example, near the Central Station and also near the Rijksmuseum. There are also special hop-on, hop-off boats in the Dutch capital. With these boats, you can hop on and off at any of the stops whenever you like. If you want to travel faster or travel a longer distance, you can use the public transport. This means that wherever you are in the city, there are buses and trams that will take you to most places. In addition to trams and buses, the city of Amsterdam offers a subway service. In Holland, it is called Metro. Moving around with it is generally faster than traveling with trams and buses. If you want to visit the northern part of the city, it is possible to use a free boat to cross the water. It is possible to step into several of these small ferries at the north side of the central station. If you want to travel by public transport, you can use a website or mobile app to plan your trip. Use for example 9292.nl or the app. And do not forget to choose for English as a display language if you do not understand the Dutch language. If you chose your way of moving around the old city center, there is a lot to see. For example, around the museum square there are several world-class museums like the Rijksmuseum, the Van Gogh Museum and the Stedelijk Museum. The Rijksmuseum is a fantastic place with great works of art. You could easily spend the whole day here because there is so much to see. The Rijksmuseum was built around the Night Watch. This is probably the most famous painting of Rembrandt. I would advise anyone to buy a ticket online before your arrival at Amsterdam to gain quick entry. Because there is so much to see, choose what you want to see using the map that you can get at the entrance. Next to the Rijksmuseum, there is the Van Gogh Museum. There are a lot of famous paintings that were painted by Van Gogh. Near the museum square is also the Stedelijk Museum. This museum is dedicated to modern art and design. On the banks of the Amstel River you can find the Hermitage Museum. The Hermitage is dedicated to art. Another interesting place to visit is the Scheepvaartmuseum. This National Maritime Museum shows you how the sea has shaped the Dutch culture. Next to the Scheepvaartmuseum, there is a replica of an old Dutch vessel called Amsterdam. The Amsterdam is one of the most stunning pieces in the museum's collection. In the 17th and 18th centuries, the Dutch set sail in ships like these to the Far East. The original ship sunk at 1749. You can also visit the Rembrandt House. This was once the home of the famous painter Rembrandt van Rijn. If you are interested in ancient history, you can visit the Archaeological Museum. You can find the Ellert Pearson Museum between the Dam Square and the Amstel River. If you are interested in the history of the city, you can visit the Amsterdam Museum. It is next to the Kalverstraat. You can enter this shopping street from the Dam Square. Located in the heart of the Dutch capital, The Royal Palace is not only one of the Dutch most famous historical buildings, it is the only palace in the country that is both in active use and available for the public to visit. Visitors are welcome to discover this historical place when the palace is not in use by the royal family. Another historical place you can visit is the Begijnhof. The Begijnhof is an enclosed courtyard dating from the early 15th century. The Begijnhof was originally built as a sanctuary for the Begijntjes, a Catholic sisterhood who lived like nuns. The Anne Frank House is a place that brings you back to the Second World War. Anne Frank was a Jewish girl who had to go into hiding during this period to escape from the Nazis. In the secret annex at the Prinsengracht, she wrote her world-famous diary. As you can see, it can be pretty busy at the former house of Anne Frank. The Anne Frank House can only be visited with a ticket bought online for a specific time slot. This is the Old Church, or in Dutch Oude Kerk. The Oude Kerk in Amsterdam's Red Light District is the city's oldest building. Not far from the Oude Kerk you can find these buildings. Can you imagine that one of the buildings does contain a church? Two buildings belong to the Our Lord in the Attic Museum. It is a uniquely preserved 17th century house from the Dutch Golden Age. You can explore the narrow corridors and climb the stairs to historically furnished rooms and visit the real church. This church was built in the attic. If you do not want to visit a museum, but just want to go to a place to relax and rest outside, you can visit the largest park of the city. It is accessible to the public every day. And if you are near the Rijksmuseum and the Van Gogh Museum, then the Vondelpark is just a few minutes walk away. To the north of the center, there is the Adam Tower. You can have a night view over the city if you visit the top of the building. Finally, I want to tell something about shopping in the city. There are a lot of streets where you can shop. If you walk from Amsterdam Central Station and take Nieuwendijk Street and Kalverstraat, you have about 2.5 kilometers of shopping fun before you arrive at Muntplein. Kalverstraat is probably the most famous shopping street in the city. If you want to shop in a more charming neighborhood, go for the 9th Streets area, or in Dutch, de Negen Straatjes. This area is a great place to visit. Of course, there is a lot more to tell about the city. If you want more information about Amsterdam while you are already in the city, you can go to the I Amsterdam Visitor Center at the Station Square. It is the official tourist office. Before you travel to Amsterdam, you can also visit the website of the tourist office. There you can, for example, order special arrangements that give you access to public transport and museums. I hope you enjoyed this video about Amsterdam. Please hit the like button if you like this video. If you want, you can also subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching.